Your Massachusetts real estate market update for April 2023. There are some crazy numbers and developments to go over this month. And if you're looking to hear about the Massachusetts real estate market for single family homes, condos, as well as multifamilies, then you're in the right place. 3 months in the books with 9 more to go, but we're starting to get a great picture as to what this year is ultimately going to look like. And I think it's safe to say that it is nothing like anybody had expected. Except for maybe in one market segment, but we'll get to that. First, I'm Jeff Chubb. I'm a recovering investment banker turned real estate agent. I've sold more than 1,000 houses. If you have any questions about real estate, then know I'm here to help. Let's start with single families. In March of 2023, we saw 2,372 single family homes sell for an average sales price of $720,000. Now, compared to March of 2022, this represents a year-over-year decrease in the number of sales by 17.5%. Now, we had been running at about 25% below sales levels month after month, so the 17.5% was a really big surprise. We knew sales levels were going to be down, and well, they're going to continue to be down for many months to come. Compared to March of 2022, home prices were up by 4.3% year over year. That one knocked me off my chair. That was much higher than my expectations. It was my prediction that sales prices were going to be flat for 2023. And I'm really starting to rethink that prediction. So sales levels were down and prices were up. Let's see where we were with a yearly comparison. The 2,372 sales put us right on target for a sales comparison of 2011, which has kind of seemed to be the story for quite some time. In 2011, there were 2,358 single family homes that sold. So for the market collapse, folks, the market, it didn't collapse in 2011 sales levels. Is it getting hard to say the market is going to collapse like it did back in 2008 with a straight face? I mean, I'm just asking for a friend. A 4.2% increase in sales prices year over year after last month's 3.5% increase might just make that the case. And for the record, the 10.3% month over month increase, it really doesn't mean anything. Month over month is not a good comparison for data, but people like talking about it, so I figured I'd give you the data point. These sales numbers were a year-over-year comparison are going to continue to look not so great for the next 5 months or so, but it's going to start to get better and better. It's the new market normal. The high interest rates have frozen the move-up market, which has now created a slowdown in the higher-end market. Because of this slowdown, we've actually seen inventory start to grow in some of those markets, slightly and slowly, but it is growing. So with the continued decrease in sales to 2011 levels, inventory must have jumped, right? Not so fast there. Inventory is the third lowest in recent history. We had 3,279 houses on the market as of the end of the month. This is compared to the 2,632 homes in March of 2022, which means we've seen a 24.6% increase in the amount of homes on the market. 647 additional homes on the market, well, that's hardly something to celebrate if you're in that doom and gloom camp. And you can see this from the single family weekly inventory chart that the inventory levels in 2023 had been shrinking and have actually been closing the gap between 2022 and is right there with 2021. The additional levels of inventory and the reduced sales have helped slow down the appreciation rate. For the first 3 months, we've seen a very sustainable 3.2% average appreciation rate. This is phenomenal news for everyone. The story of the real estate market is, and it's going to continue to be, about inventory levels. Not sales levels, inventory levels. Inventory levels in 2011 were more than 600% higher than they are today. 600%. So what are my thoughts for March in the single family market? Sales levels, well, they made sense and were actually a little better than I would have thought. Inventory levels are exactly where I thought they would be. Appreciation was higher than what I would have expected. And I'm downright shocked at an appreciation rate that's more than 4% higher year over year. I was talking to a friend and they were saying how another friend sold their house and have been renting in an Avalon community for the last year, just waiting for prices to go down. I gave a I feel bad for them kind of laugh. And just thought about how many more people like this have been screwed by just some awful advice. They sold their house and thereby lost out on that house's appreciation while moving into an expensive rental where they lost out on 100% of the rental payment each and every single month to only enter a market that has continued to move away from them and gotten more expensive, all while interest rates went up. Don't get caught up in the day-to-day. Buy for the long run and you will be in good shape. Oh, and maybe don't take advice for real estate from your dentist. I've said it before, and I'm going to continue to say it. until I am blue in the face. You can't have a price correction without a surge of inventory. This is what has made our market so different compared to the many other markets in the southern part of the country. To check in with my prediction of 2023, I said that our market was going to be flat. A quarter in the books and an average appreciation rate of 3.1% is starting to make me think I might have been wrong. I'm not 100% ready to admit defeat and move off of my prediction because the spring market, well, it's coming, and it's going to be compared to a time period last year when people were just scrambling to get into houses right before the uptick in rates, which thereby pushed up prices, well, a lot. But with a quarter of the year down, the market is showing how resilient it is. While I won't move off the fence on the appreciation side just yet, I can say with near certainty that I see there is no way that home prices are going to go down in 2023 in the state of Massachusetts. So on to the condo market and then the multifamily market. But first, if you like hearing about the Massachusetts real estate market, then please consider subscribing. And I can't tell you how much I appreciate you hitting that like button, as it makes a huge difference to those YouTube gods. For the month of March in the condo market, we saw 1,277 condos close in March for an average sales price of $662,000. The seesaw of the Massachusetts condo prices, well, it continues. More on that one in a moment. The number of sales were down 21.4% year over year in March. This was expected and, well, more of the same. In January, sales were down by 24.8%. In February, they were down 24.7%. So if anything, they were actually down a little from what we had seen from the two prior months, which is a good thing. Continue to expect to see this year-over-year decline in sales for another 5 months or so, but it's going to continually get better and better. The sales levels of 1,277 units sold in March 2023 were equal to the levels of March of 2014 when we hit 1,269 units sold. And in case you were wondering, we saw an appreciation rate of 5.9% in 2014. Okay, so sales were down as we expected, but what about the seesaw effect that I was talking about with prices? In March of 2023, condo prices were up by 5%. Well, hold on, because this has been a heck of a ride. In November of 2022, they were up by 8%, then they were down 2% in December, then they were up by nearly 9% in January, then they were down 3% in February 2023, and well, now they're back up to 5%. Should we place our bets for next month? So sales were down, prices were up. Let's take a look at what happened in inventory levels. At the end of March, we had 2,101 condos on the market. This is up 13% from March of last year when there were 1,858 units on the market, but 12.8% below the March 2021 number when there were 2,411 units on the market. Still, the second lowest inventory levels in recent history. So no issues there. Well, for sellers, there are no issues. For buyers, it kind of sucks to hear, quite frankly. But now onto the multifamily market. I said last month that if I had to pick a market that I am most bearish on, then it would be the multifamily market. Still not changing that, though. So now let's jump into the market that was down, way down. First, a recap as to why I'm down on the multifamily market. Multifamily's main attraction is for investors. And when it comes to investing, it is all about dollars and cents. No one buys a multifamily property to lose money on a monthly carry each month. And with the cost of debt, this is exactly what would happen for a lot of buyers. And for the buyers that are looking to buy a multifamily property to have the tenants help pay their mortgage, what is interesting is that in a lot of those cases, the new homeowner would actually end up subsidizing some of the tenant's rent. It doesn't make sense for a lot of folks. Buying a multifamily property is not the end-all and be-all that it's made out to be. Sometimes they make sense. Other times, they don't. It takes a good qualified agent to help you identify the situations when it makes sense or not. In March of 2023, there were 440 properties that sold for an average sales price of $726,000. Year over year, sales were down 26.4%, which was a big improvement from the last 3 months, where we had sales down 43.9% in December of 2022, and then 40.7% in January, 41.4% in February. So very nice improvement in the unit sales, still down 26%, but it's going in the right direction. But I'm thinking that the increase in sales, well, they came at a cost. And that cost was the average sales price, because prices were down by 8.3% year over year. This also means that in the last 4 months, the multifamily market has had prices down for 3 out of 4 of them. Now let's take a peek at the multifamily inventory levels. As of the end of March, we had 607 multifamily properties on the market. Inventory levels today are 17.6% below the levels this time last year. This makes for a new historical reference point as the lowest level of inventory in the month of March in recent history. And as I said last month, this all makes sense. Sellers aren't getting the price that they want, so they just take the property off the market and enjoy the fat returns that they're getting on a monthly carry. I would say that most investors, they don't really have a dying need to sell right now, which will help with keeping prices elevated and ensure that there will be no crash in prices. Again, I believe that the multifamily market is the weakest of all markets in the state of Massachusetts. Want to talk about your own personal real estate needs? All of my contact information, it's in the description below. I always love to talk about real estate. So whether you're looking to buy or sell a house in the next 9 or 90 days, then I would love to chat with you and just find out a little bit more about your real estate goals. You can also visit me at youtuberealestateagent.com. Just fill in your information and then I'm going to reach out to you. Questions or comments about the market data, then drop me a line in that comment section below. You take the time to watch the video, so I'm always going to take the time to answer your questions. An informed person, they're a powerful person. So until next time.